Welcome to the class. Today we will discuss about chest injury. Like various type of injury, like head injury, chest injury, fracture, polytrauma, occur due to various types of causes, like fall from height, road traffic accident, sports injury, etc. The chest is a large exposed portion of the body that is vulnerable to impact. In the chest houses the heart, lung and great vessels. So chest trauma is frequently in any client, the chest trauma should be considered to have a serious injury, and injury to the chest or thorax are responsible for 25% of all trauma death. Now we will discuss what is the chest injury. Injuries to the chest wall and its underlying structure are sustained largely by road traffic accidents, fall from height and other causes. That is called chest trauma or chest injury. So what are the related anatomy and physiology? The related anatomy of chest injury, there is a thoracic cage or thoracic cavity, the bony structure, that is ribs, sternum, shoulder girdle and intercostal muscles covered by skin. This also chest wall. And another is the underlying structure of the thoracic cavity that contains trachea, right and left bronchi, right and left lungs, pulmonary arteries, pulmonary veins, pleura, pleural cavity, diaphragm, mediastinum. These all are the related anatomy of the chest wall and its underlying structure. And in addition, there is in mediastinum containing the heart, thoracic aorta, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, aorta, trachea and many other blood vessels and nerves are there. So what are the physiology of lungs or chest cavity? The normal process of functions of lung is to replenish the oxygen in the blood, thereby delivering oxygen to the tissues and removing carbon dioxide from blood through respiration. The mechanisms of respiration has three phases, that is inspiration, expiration and a pause, and the chest wall facilitate the respiration. Now the etiology of the chest injury. Mainly two types of trauma or injury causes chest trauma. One is the blunt trauma, another is the penetrating trauma or injuries. Blunt trauma to the chest may cause injury by one or a combination of three mechanisms, namely deceleration, direct impact and compression. Due to road traffic accident, motor vehicle accident, the steering wheels, belt, this cause chest injury, and fall from height, fall onto the object, sports injury, blunt trauma by violence and accidental injury due to the direct compression during CPR, that is the life-saving procedure. And another is the penetrating trauma or injuries may be caused by an object entering and potentially crossing the chest wall, that is stab wound, arrow wound, gunshot injury, etc. Now see the pictures. This is the motor vehicle accident, sports injury, fall from height and another. This is the picture of the penetrating chest injury. And the classification of the chest injury. Injuries to the chest wall, that is chest wall contusion or hematomas, ribs fracture. Ribs fracture can range from very simple to more complex injuries such as flail segment or flail chest, the simple rib fracture, complex rib fracture, First fracture, sternal fracture, and fractures of the shoulder girdle. Internal structure injuries to the pulmonary injury. Pulmonary injuries and injuries involving the pleural space, that is pulmonary contusion, pleural injury, laceration, pneumothorax, hemothorax, and hemopneumothorax. Another injury to the airways and heart, that is tracheobronchial tear, cardiac injury, that is pericardial tamponade, myocardial contusion, and traumatic arrest. Blood vessels injuries, that is traumatic aortic rupture, thoracic aorta injury, aortic dissection, and injuries to the other structure within the torso, that is esophageal injury and diaphragmatic injury. So now we discuss about the various types of injury of the chest wall and its underlying structure with its clinical features and management. So first one is the simple ribs fracture. Common from the blunt injury to any part of the chest. Clinical features: pain on inspiration and expiration, crepitus, bony tenderness, bruising, seat belt marking, dyspnea, reducing lung expansion, respiration increased or decreased, shallow respiration, acute pain over the injury site. And diagnosis of the chest injury, mainly clinical examination, history taking, physical examination, and confirmative diagnosis is the chest X-ray and CRCT. What is the management of the simple ribs fracture? No therapeutic intervention is required for the simple rib fracture. Only effective pain management is there, and simple breathing exercise, splinting of the chest wall movement during respiration. And second one is the complex ribs fracture. It is most commonly in the 4th to 10th ribs associated with or without splenic or hepatic injury. Its clinical manifestations mainly as simple ribs fracture. In addition of these clinical features, subcutaneous emphysema may occur due to complex ribs fracture. And here the diagnosis also same: history, physical assessment, X-ray, and CRCT or CT scan. Management of the complex ribs fracture: if 4 or more ribs fracture, must be admitted in hospital. Pain management by analgesic, physiotherapy, chest tube drainage, open or closed water seal drainage may be needed. And first ribs or rib fracture, side penetrating trauma or blunt injury of the first rib. Its clinical features also same as simple rib fracture. And clinical manifestation by history taking, chest X-ray, CRCT may be needed for confirmative diagnosis. Management also may be pain management by giving analgesic, physiotherapy, chest tube drainage open or closed with water seal drainage. Another type of chest injury is sternal fracture. This penetrating trauma or blunt injury associated with or without underlying injury, that is cardiac contusion, great vessels injury, etc. It is mainly clinical features same as complex rib fracture and sternal pain. Here the diagnosis are also same: history taking, physical assessment, chest X-ray, and CT scan. Management also same as first rib fracture, that is pain management, physiotherapy, and close or open water seal drainage. Another is the most important and critical chest injury is the frail chest. It is occurring due to the blunt trauma from a steering wheel injury. It usually occurs when three or more adjacent ribs are fractured at two or more sites, resulting free floating ribs segment. Mainly the clinical manifestations are same as complex rib fracture. In addition, paradoxical chest wall movement and hypoxia. Investigation by clinical examination, history taking, physical examination, chest x-ray and CRCT. Management, mainly pain management and epidural analgesia may be needed. Physiotherapy, chest tube drainage, open or closed, water seal drainage, intercostal nerve block, ABG analysis, mechanical ventilation, and in rare case, surgical fixation of fractured ribs are needed.